The only way to create a new cell is to duplicate a pre-existing one. The original cell is called the parent cell, and the two new cells, which are genetically identical, are called daughter cells. The series of steps leading to and involving the duplication of a cell is called the cell cycle. The cell cycle involves cell growth, chromosome replication, chromosome segregation, and cell division. These processes take place over the course of the four sequential phases of the cell cycle, G1, S, G2, and M. The first three phases are together called interphase. Most cells need more time to grow and double their organelles and biomolecules than they need to duplicate and divide up their chromosomes. The gap phases, G1 and G2, provide the time needed for this growth, and also give the cell time to assess whether the environment is favorable for division, and whether all the preparations for cell division have been appropriately completed. Eukaryotic cells have a complex system of regulatory proteins, called the cell cycle control system, to make sure that cell division occurs correctly and only when appropriate. Taking place between G1 and G2, S phase is when DNA replicates and chromosomes duplicate. It is critical that this replication is accurate and that every nucleotide is copied exactly once. Here it is important to discuss two closely related and commonly confused terms, chromosomes and chromatids. Before replication, the term chromosome refers to a continuous strand of DNA, but during replication, the term chromosome refers to the two sister chromatids linked together with a centromere. These sister chromatids include the original chromosome and its identical replica. So to recap, you have a chromosome, then after DNA replication, you have a chromosome made up of sister chromatids. When cell division takes place, the sister chromatids are separated, resulting in two daughter chromosomes. Note the difference between haploid and diploid cells. Haploid cells have one set of chromosomes. However, most animals are diploid organisms. In diploid cells, there are two sets of chromosomes present at the start of the cell cycle, one from mom, one from dad. So for example, in humans, there are 46 chromosomes, 23 from each parent. When your DNA is replicated, your cells still have 46 chromosomes, each of which is a pair of sister chromatids. After the sister chromatids separate, with one of each pair going to each new cell, the new cells also end up with 46 chromosomes in each cell. Finally, we come to M phase, which includes mitosis and cytokinesis. Mitosis is the process by which sister chromatids are split up equally between the two new daughter nuclei, so that each new cell can have an identical and complete version of the genome. Cytokinesis is the division of the cytoplasm. Before we describe what happens during mitosis, it is important to define the mitotic spindle and centrosomes. The mitotic spindle is what eukaryotes use to separate chromosomes into two new daughter cells. It is a bipolar array of microtubules that pulls sister chromatids apart. These microtubules have minus ends focused at the spindle poles and plus ends that radiate outwards. Microtubules are composed of tubulin subunits, which can get added or removed from the plus end of the microtubule, making it grow or shrink. There are three types of microtubules in the mitotic spindle. Interpolar microtubules are those whose plus ends interact with the plus ends of interpolar microtubules originating from the opposite spindle pole. Astral microtubules radiate outward from the poles to contact the cell cortex. Their job is to position the spindle in the cell. Finally, there are the kinetochore microtubules, whose positive ends are attached to sister chromatid pairs at kinetochores. Kinetochores are large protein structures located at the centromere of each sister chromatid. The kinetochores are built on the heterochromatin that forms at the centromeric region of the chromosome. The kinetochores allow the plus ends of kinetochore microtubules to be embedded in special attachment sites in the kinetochore. An animal cell kinetochore can have 10 to 40 of these attachment sites. The attachment sites contain a protein collar that secures the microtubule but still allows the addition or removal of tubulin subunits to its end. Kinetochores allow kinetochore microtubules to attach correctly to sister chromatids. How? Well, if there is an imbalance in microtubule attachment, such as if two microtubules from opposite spindle poles attach to the same sister chromatid, the attachment is unstable. However, the correct attachment gets locked in place. In animal cells, at each spindle pole, there is a single centrosome, which consists of two centrioles oriented perpendicular to one another, surrounded by the paracentriolar matrix. The paracentriolar matrix nucleates a radial array of microtubules, whose negative ends are associated with the centrosome. Like the genome, the centrosome must be duplicated exactly one time prior to mitosis. An incorrect number of centrosomes would result in errors in spindle assembly and chromosome segregation. This duplication occurs at the start of S phase. Finally, we come to mitosis, the division of identical genomic information between the two nuclei. Mitosis has five stages: prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. During prophase, chromosomes condense within the nucleus, with each chromosome consisting of two linked sister chromatids. Outside the nucleus, the mitotic spindle assembles between two centrosomes. Next, we have prometaphase, which begins when the nuclear envelope breaks down. This means that chromosomes can now attach to spindle microtubules. This occurs via kinetochores and results in the movement of the chromosomes. Metaphase involves the alignment of chromosomes along the equator of the spindle, with microtubules attaching sister chromatids to opposite poles of the spindle. Anaphase involves the synchronized separation of sister chromatids to form two daughter chromosomes, which are pulled towards the spindle poles. During this process, not only do the kinetochore microtubules shorten, but the spindle poles also move apart. Telophase is the last stage of mitosis. At this point, the two sets of daughter chromosomes arrive at the spindle poles and decondense. The formation of the two nuclei, which occurs when a nuclear envelope assembles around the two genomes, means that mitosis is over. Cytokinesis, which is the division of the cytoplasm, occurs during mitosis. In animal cells, it begins in anaphase and ends in telophase. It occurs thanks to the formation of a contractile ring of actin and myosin filaments, which form a rapidly deepening furrow. The contractile ring begins to assemble during anaphase, just beneath the plasma membrane. As the ring contracts, there is formation of an intercellular bridge and fusion of intracellular vesicles to add more plasma membrane to compensate for the extra surface area. At the center of the intercellular bridge, there is what is called the midbody, which consists of the remains of the interdigitated interpolar microtubules at the spindle midzone, which are packed together within a dense matrix material. Abscission is the final cleaving of the two daughter cells, so cytokinesis has four steps: initiation, contraction, membrane insertion, and completion. Note that plant cells do things differently. You may recall that plant cells not only have a plasma membrane, but also a cell wall. At the start of telophase, once chromosomes have been segregated, assembly of a new cell wall begins at the equator of the old spindle. Once the plasma membrane fuses with the membrane surrounding the new cell wall, the two daughter cells are separated. Finally, I'd like to point out that some cells undergo nuclear division but not cytokinesis. This results in a cell with multiple nuclei called a syncytium. An example of this happening is in the Drosophila embryo, which undergoes multiple rounds of nuclear division. The nuclei then arrange in a monolayer near the surface. Finally, membranes are created around these nuclei through a coordinated cytokinesis process called cellularization. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe. You can also support me by following the link to my Patreon. If you have any topics you'd like me to cover, please leave a comment.